Kia ora guys, welcome to another episode of Daily Races for the 13th of February. So today we've got the one race today, which is the Group 4 race around Dragon Trail. So let's jump into it, and today we'll use the... where is it? There it is, the McGann. That's all fine. Now put these pedals into view. Reset that.
Thank you.
just reset that. I might be able to get in one more lap. Nope, never mind. Thank you. Oh, wrong view. Oh shit. Oh, there's a big crash then. Thank you. We'll just... This guy walks pretty aggressively. Okay, people are coming into the pits. Cool. Hey there, mate. Sorry I can't get to your message. I've got 13th position pretty much secure. Go and across the line in 12th position. So I started in 8th, I think. Yeah, 8th position I started in. Had a huge crash on the first lap. Took out a few drivers with me. Yeah. Yeah, he was in a TT. Okay, cool. Alright. Come on, give me something different. I don't care what it is, as long as it's something different. I think this is my third one of these. Yep, there we go. 1, 2, 3. Wonder what the other doubles I have. There's another double. Another one. Another one. Another few there. Yeah, so yeah, there are a lot. Nothing really happened to the driver rating. Okay, well, considering that there's only one event that I was playing to, that, well, excuse me. Seeing as there is only one event in the daily races, I figured I'll have another crack at the Stefan Beloff challenge. So I'll tell you what the Stefan Beloff challenge is. So pretty much it's to get this I made a challenge to people who downloaded this livery that I made, and I challenged them to get this car around the track, around the Nordschleife, in under 6 minutes and 11 seconds. And with balance of performance turned on, so I'm able to do it on controller pretty effortlessly, but I haven't really tried it on a wheel, so let's give it a crack. Okay, so requirements, balance of performance must be on. Yeah, and if you see my lap times there on the right, achieved a 6:05, but I think I had BOP off during then and I was doing it on controller. So let's give it a shot. Get me out of this view. Get me into that one. Thank you. big crash. Let's see if I can see that one on the replay. Skip ahead a bit. Whoa! That's a Le Mans worthy crash. Alright, let's try that again. Damn it. That lost me a bit of time. Thank you. Oh shit. Rule note, stay away from that dirt. Oh shit. So close too. Damn it. Well, hang on a second. Oh, what have I done? Damn it. Come on, getting back on the track. I might be able to salvage this. Thank you. no, damn it. Whew. No, no, no! It was going good, too. Oh geez, I wasn't even concentrating then. I didn't lose too much time on that. damn it, did it again.
Okay, now
taking it extra cautiously around this section. Aha, got you this time. Come on, get me back on the track. I might be able to salvage this. Nope. Oh, I might. Seconds. Oh shit. Shit. Come on, get me back on the track. Oh, easy. Okay, whew. So that was a time of 6:06. There were about three sections at the end there where I messed up. I could have gotten that down to like 6.4, 6.5 maybe. Oh, that was good. I like that. Let's watch the replay. How these cars corner or go through the corners. I find these cars to be like rather ugly when they're standing still, but when they're in motion they look awesome. Okay, that bit right there used to be my hated part of the track. It took me forever to try and figure out how to get through that. And one of the things I learned is don't touch the curbs or the rumble strips or whatever you want to call them, because if you touch them going through those bends, yeah, you're going to spin out. I think that even Jeremy Clarkson said that too. When you're going around those set of turns, don't touch the curbs. Oh. Look at that. Look at how that thing went around that bend. That was cutting it close. Yeah, I think that's where I missed. That corner right there is where I messed up a few times. And when I finally nailed it, I got a mess up in the second carousel. So that'll teach me for opening up my big mouth, and then I mess up here again. Mainly because on. Oh, let's go back. Where is it? Just change the view. Yeah, look at that, that's terrible. That will stop it there. How do I change the view? Okay, so on the inside of this corner there, like just a little bit after where the rumble strip starts, the corner is not flat. There's a little dip there. And if you, like, ride the inside of that corner, you're going to hit that dip and it's going to bounce your car up and you're going to crash into that wall. That's why I keep on avoiding it. But as you can see, even that doesn't even stop me from crashing. Went in there way too hot, but I managed to salvage it and pull off a 6 minute and 6 seconds. Which is pretty damn alright. I can do the Stefan Beloff challenge on a controller pretty good, and I can now do it on the wheel pretty good. So yeah, not a hard challenge if you're keen to do it. Just go onto the Discover page, go into liveries, and some of the keywords you want to look for are Rothmans, Porsche 956, I believe it is. the last one is Stefan Belloff. B-E-L-L-O-F. I hope I'm spelling that correctly. Oh well, that was embarrassing, you didn't show up. Or another thing you can do. Is just look up my username there on the top left. And you'll be able to find it. With my other one, so you got version 1, 2, and the final one there. So, yeah, the description reads, yeah. Final version, changed logos on the fin, added logos on the spoiler and bonnet, and the Porsche badge on the front. But before that, I had this. If you download this livery, you accept the Stefan Belloff Challenge. Get the Porsche around the Nordschleife. In under 6 minutes and 11 seconds, BOP must be turned on. So that's a challenge to all you guys. As you can see, it's pretty easy. Yeah, I might as well show this one off too. I figured if you named your car the Vulcan, why not do an Enterprise version? This is very, very simple one. Just a silver paint scheme. Got the USS Enterprise on the bonnet there with the... with the NC-1701, and it says Spock on the back of this car, because why not? So there you go, just look up my details, my username to find these, and you should be right. Oops. Okay guys, I think that'll do it for tonight. Thank you very much for tuning in, and I will see you tomorrow. Take care guys, good night.